This video is for the students who are preparing for NTA NET June 2020. So this is only beneficial for the students who are preparing for June 2020 or December 2020, because this December 2019 examination is just like 2 or 3 months away. So it's better that we focus on June 2020 subjects. The students who are starting their preparation right now, it's better to focus on that examination. Now in this video, we will be giving some general strategies related to exam preparation as well as some of the discount that we are offering for exam preparation. So if you are interested in taking our courses, or if you are interested to have some general preparation strategies, obviously you can watch this video, and this video will be very, very beneficial for you. There are students who are very late in the exam preparation, because sometimes it happens that students, it takes time for students to figure out when should they start their preparation, or what should be their future goals. It happens all the time that before examination, 1 month before the examination or 2 months before the examination, student come to us and they ask us, sir, I want to prepare for December examination, how can I prepare? So it's very simple, guys. You cannot prepare for NTA NET examination in just 1 or 2 months, because this examination is comparatively tough. The number of subjects that you have are very lengthy. The syllabus is very lengthy. You have approximately 23 subjects that we have already seen, and we have already created a lot of videos regarding this. You can see the previous paper analysis of the NTA NET examinations. We are creating the paper analysis since 2017, so you can see the paper analysis on our website from June 2017, December 2017, then June or July 2018, December 2018, and so on. So we are constantly creating this kind of paper analysis. There are a lot of content that we have already uploaded, which are kind of a guidance videos. You can take benefit of those videos to prepare your exam strategy, because these videos are going to be very helpful for you. I'll just do one thing. It's for your understanding. I'm going to link some of those videos in the comment section as well as in the description section of those videos, this video. So you can go through those videos, and obviously those videos will help you to make your own preparation strategy. So see, there are a few common tips that I can give you, or anyone can give you. See, the syllabus of the examination is very, very lengthy. Now if you are preparing now, if you are planning to prepare for December examination, it's my personal suggestion that instead of focusing on December, it's better to focus on June examination. There are two reasons. Number one, so as I told you that the competition in the June examination is much less as compared to the competition in December examination. The reason is most of the students in India, they finish their college session in the month of April to July. So sometimes some colleges also finish their session in the month of August. So 90% of the students who are finishing these sessions, maybe they have finished their MSc, IIT, maybe they have finished their MCL, maybe they have finished their MTech. So 90% of the students who finish their MTech or MSc or their masters, they now plan to do higher studies. Either they want to go for assistant professorship or they want to go for PhDs. Now that is the reason why, if you see the total statistics, the number of students who appear in the December examination, that is much higher as compared to the number of students who are appearing for the June examination. So it's better if you prepare for the June examination, then your competition will be comparatively very, very less, and it's, you have a better chances to clear the examination with a good with good marks. Fine. So this is one thing that you should take in mind. Now secondly, when you start your preparation, you should have a complete overview of the examination. You should know what are the number of subjects, what is the marks distribution of each of the subjects, what are the topics which are very important, what are the subjects or topics that you can leave. We have already created many videos regarding this. Just visit our YouTube channel, you will see a lot of videos where we have done the proper and thorough subject analysis, and you can figure out there are many subjects here that you can easily leave. For example, in mobile computing, they have not asked any question. Hardly they asked one question from mobile computing. From linear programming is a very lengthy subject, and the time that will take to solve one question for linear programming is approximately half an hour. But if you see that number of marks that they are asking from linear programming, that is hardly one question. This is hardly one question. In the same way, there are many, many subjects that you can leave. Out of these 23 subjects, you can easily leave 5 to 6 subjects. You only have to focus on 17 to 18 subjects. Now, out of these 17 to 18 subjects, you should know what are the portions that you can leave, and you should know what are the portions you should focus on. Because this, knowing this thing is very, very important, and this is going to, you can create a strategy accordingly. We have created a lot of videos regarding this. You can see the videos in the comment section. Now, secondly, there should be a precise and correct preparation strategies. what happens is, I've seen a lot of students in the past also, in our sessions also, we have seen a lot of students. They're very brilliant students. They're very, you know, intelligent student, hardworking student. But the problem is when they study one subject, they go too deep into the subject. They start doing research on the subject. Or sometimes I've seen people who are spending like 2 or 3 months in just one single subject because they're not even satisfied with their preparation. They are just like perfectionist. You don't have to be a perfectionist to clear this exam. You don't have to perfectionist to clear JRF. Only thing that they are asking is the width of your knowledge, how wide you know. So if you are just going to spend like 6 months in 5 to 6 subjects, that is going to waste your time. You have to complete all these 15 to 18 subjects in these 6 to 8 months. And you should have knowledge of every subject. You should have knowledge of every topic somehow. There should be some knowledge of every topic. You are not going to do PhD on 1 or 2 topics, right? So that is why it is very, very important. Now, make it very clear. See, on an average, a student is able to complete 2 or at maximum 3 subjects in a month. If you are preparing through some coaching institution or if you are preparing through video lectures, it's like you are going to finish like 2 or 3 subjects in a month. So that means if you are finishing 3 subjects in a month, that is very, very good if you can do it, because that means on 10 days, within 10 days you are completing one subject. You cannot do it without any coaching, you cannot do it without any external help or external study material. You have to go through the subjects thoroughly, right? So let us assume that you are preparing 3 subjects in a month. Now, to complete the syllabus, to complete the 18 subjects out of 23, you need at least 6 months in that case. And a part of this, you have to do practice, you have to solve as much questions as possible, and there are a lot of other things, there are a lot of other examinations that will come up, a lot of things disturb you. So it's better that you have to take your time. At least 8 months is required, I should suggest you. If you are doing self-preparation, it will take you like 1 year. If you are doing any coaching, it will take you like 6 months to 8 months just to complete the subject. And if you are thinking that you can prepare the subjects in 2 or 3 months, obviously this cannot be done unless you have done any prior preparation. So it's better that if you are focusing on the June, this is the right time, that right now you should think about the examination. Right now you should start your preparation, because you'll be having ample time. You'll be having 8 months. In 8 months you can take like 6 months to finish your syllabus. In the last 2 months you can take to practice the subjects, and you can even take the last 2 months in revising the concepts and practicing as much papers as possible. This is the minimum I can suggest, okay? And the second, thirdly, is start early, as I said, and prepare notes. It is very, very important, because the number of subjects you have is like very big, very huge. The number of subjects is like 18-20. So it is a general tendency that when you start second or third subject, you start forgetting the first subject. So whenever you are preparing from the video lectures, or whenever you are preparing from your coaching institution, just do one thing: prepare thorough notes as well as prepare short notes. Whenever after the end of the week, whatever you have studied in the whole week, just prepare short notes, which can be concise note, like 1 or 2 pages, so that you can do a quick revision with that. Okay, so this is very, very important for all of you, that you have to revise the subjects periodically. Before the examination, you have to revise the entire syllabus at least 2 or 3 times. You should solve every questions at least 2 or 3 times before the examination. And secondly, you should prepare short notes so that when you are revising, it will not take you long time to revise the complete subject, okay? And third is, you can learn from the qualified students. You can see that we have already uploaded video lectures or the video testimonials and the student experience from many students who qualified JRF, many students who qualified assistant professor. You can just visit our channel. You can find tons and tons of videos, at least like I guess 30 to 40 video we have already posted till now from the students who are the top rankers of the examination. Not just the UGC NET, not just the NTA NET, but also from other examinations like ISRO, DRDO, GATE. We have already posted hundreds of video, like I think 100 or 200 or 100 plus videos are there for preparation strategy, as well as like 30 to 40 students who actually cleared JRF. They created videos, so you can learn from their experience how they planned their preparation, how much time it took them to prepare for the entire examination. So there are a lot of students who have cleared the examination, who got into top rank, so you can learn from their experience, right? And it's very important to solve the previous year question. Now the main important point here is the UGC NET examination, or you can see this now we call it as NTA net. So this NTA net examination, recently there are a lot of changes in the examination. They earlier from 2018, before 2018 we were following a very old syllabus. Now the syllabus is also changed, the exam pattern is also changed. Earlier they used to be a subjective examination, then they changed to objective examination. Nowadays they are taking online examination, so the exam pattern is also changed. See, previous year questions are important. The most important question that you have to practice is 2017 onwards, because from 2017 onwards they started making a lot of changes in the examination pattern. So it's better that you should actually focus on the questions which they asked from after 2017. And secondly, you should also solve gate questions. If you're preparing for NTA, you should also solve gate questions, because many questions out of like 100 questions, like 10 to 15 questions, they're asking from previous year gate papers only. Exact same questions are coming. And if you're say asking the questions which are based on the same concept, 50% of your paper is from gate. Right, so which is actually based on exact same concepts. So it's better that if you are doing internet exam preparation, you should solve the gate question papers as well. You should also solve ISRO question papers. I can give you proof of many questions which are directly asked from these examinations. These questions are basically rotating in all of these examinations. So it's better that you prepare from these questions also. Okay, and the last but not the least, that if you want to prepare for using live classes or video lectures, right now the huge discount is going on in our website. So it is a current Navratri discount, because as you know, current Navratri is going on. So in this month of Navratri, we are having these huge discounts for the video lectures, as well as there are huge discounts for the live classes also. So what is the discount? Let me just summarize this one. If you are taking a 1 year subscription, with this you are going to get 2 months extra. And right now the fees is 17,000. See, the fees for this is actually 24,000, but with discount right now the fees is 17,000. I have not written the actual fees here. I have written the discounted fees here. And you are also getting 2 months extra. So in 17,000 plus tax, you are going to get approximately 14 months of subscription. Now here in this case, this is a 6 month subscription. The fees is around 15,000. But again, there's a discount going on, Navratri discount going on. So that is why currently the fees is 11,500, where you are going to get 3 months extra. And here this is a 3 months course, where you are also going to get a mini test series. And this, the fees is 6,500 plus tax. Now this is also for the students who want to renew their subscription, who have already taken the subscription in the previous year or maybe the previous session. Now if you want to renew your subscription, it's better that you do it within Navratri, because again you are going to get huge benefit with this. Again, you are going to get a lot of updated material. So it's better that you renew your subscription. It's better you buy a subscription right now, because again, as I said, for June examination, you have to start preparation right now. You have to start your entire preparation at this moment. If you start right now, then only you will be able to finish your syllabus. Then only you will be able to get a good rank. Then only you will be able to clear GRF. It is very, very important for all of you. Trust me, guys, this is very important. Okay. And if you have any doubts, any inquiries, please call us on the number which is given in this video, as well as you can also find our contact number and website link on the comment section of this video and the video description. Okay, if you have any doubts, just feel free to call us and we'll be happy to answer all of your doubts. Okay, thank you so much for watching. All the best.